Malaysia is at a tipping point. The tech world is taking notice as global giants flood the country with billions of dollars in investments. But can Malaysia seize this moment and rise to become the next semiconductor superpower? Over the past few years, Malaysia has become a hotbed for tech investment. Tech titans like Intel and Infineon are pouring in $7 billion each, while Nvidia is gearing up to build a $4.3 billion AI data center. Texas Instruments isn't holding back either, with $3.1 billion allocated for two new semiconductor assembly plants. But that's just scratching the surface. Malaysia is attracting a wave of foreign capital from industry leaders like Germany's Bosch, Austria's AT&S, Sweden's Ericsson, South Korea's Semtech, and major Chinese state-backed players like Fengshire Metal Technology. With all this, Malaysia's business scene is thriving. Ambitions and strategy. The Malaysian government wants to turn this momentum into long-term success by positioning the country as a high-tech economy, following in the footsteps of Japan, South Korea, and Taiwan. But becoming a tech powerhouse isn't a straightforward path. Malaysia's semiconductor ambitions hinge on securing $107 billion in investments to truly become a global hub. If it falls short, the country could become entangled in global tensions, especially as it navigates the delicate balance between the US and China. Alongside its domestic efforts, Malaysia is also becoming a key player in the China Plus One strategy, where multinational companies seek to diversify their production and sourcing beyond China. Despite growing competition from neighboring countries like Indonesia, Thailand, and Vietnam, Malaysia remains an attractive option for businesses due to its strategic location, stable governance, and strong infrastructure. This expansion into Malaysia further cements the country's role as a rising semiconductor hub in the region. The journey won't be without its hurdles. One of Malaysia's most pressing issues is its brain drain. Although the country produces well-educated talent, many skilled workers are leaving for higher-paying opportunities abroad, creating a labor shortage of over 1.2 million people, half of them in crucial sectors like engineering and manufacturing. To achieve its ambitious goals, Malaysia is aggressively working to bridge a significant talent gap in the semiconductor industry. The country currently needs an additional 60,000 engineers to meet its targets by 2030. This talent shortage has become a pressing issue, and the government is implementing a 3RS strategy: recruit, retain, and return. Efforts include hiring fresh talent, preventing brain drain, and enticing Malaysian engineers working abroad to return. Industry players like Infineon and Maystorage are already taking steps to build local expertise, with hubs in Puchong and Penang playing a pivotal role in growing the talent pool. On top of that, Malaysia is seeing housing prices soar, especially in places like Penang, where foreign investment has driven costs up. Rent controls offer temporary relief, but long-term solutions are still out of reach. Then there's the political landscape. Malaysia has seen four different prime ministers in the last 4 years. For global corporations, political stability is critical, and these rapid changes make foreign investors wary. At the heart of the global tech race lies artificial intelligence, robotics, and green technology, industries worth over $600 billion and growing. Malaysia is uniquely positioned with its existing semiconductor industry, strong infrastructure, and skilled English-speaking workforce. Currently, the country holds a 13% global market share in semiconductor assembly, testing, and packaging, contributing a significant 25% of Malaysia's GDP. However, competition in the region is fierce. Singapore, Thailand, and Vietnam are all vying for dominance, with massive investments from global players like Samsung and TSMC. Despite the competition, Malaysia is making bold moves. It has rolled out the Industrial Master Plan 2030 to attract more high-end semiconductor production and wafer fabrication, looking to leverage local companies like Estera and Upstart Technology. Penang, once a small fishing village, has transformed into one of Malaysia's tech success stories. Home to more than 350 multinational corporations, Penang accounts for an estimated 5% of global semiconductor exports. The government's revival plans for Penang include a new 1 million square foot industrial park, with major names like Jabil and Western Digital already showing interest. But as Malaysia's tech dreams expand, so do the risks. While the U.S. remains Malaysia's largest investor, China has been its top trading partner for 15 years. Any misstep in this delicate dance could lead to economic sanctions that would cripple Malaysia's semiconductor ambitions overnight. Recent allegations that Malaysian firm Getronics supplied strategic electronic components to Russia have only heightened these concerns, signaling how quickly geopolitics can turn on a dime. The stakes are higher than ever for Malaysia. With billions in foreign investments flooding the country, the opportunities are immense, but so are the risks. Malaysia needs to go big, adapt fast, and skillfully navigate the global political landscape, or risk losing its shot at becoming a global tech giant.